In this module, we will discuss MLE based on truncated or restricted parameter space. In module 1, we discussed the basic notions of maximum likelihood estimation and maximum likelihood estimators along with some introductory examples. So far we discussed there, no restriction was imposed on the parameter space. In fact, it would allow the parameter theta to vary over its all possible feasible values. Say for example, theta belongs to the open interval 0 to 1 in case of Bernoulli theta. Now, if the parameter space is restricted or truncated or curtailed, say like theta belongs to the closed interval 1/4 to 1 for Bernoulli theta, then MLE may change. In the present module, we will discuss the maximum likelihood estimator and its characteristics under restricted parameter space. The theme of the present module is the maximum likelihood estimation based on truncated parameter space. In module 1, we studied some basic notions about maximum likelihood estimation and maximum likelihood estimators or estimates along with some introductory examples. So far we studied there, no restriction was imposed on the parameter space. It would allow to vary theta over all possible feasible values. For example, parameter space was 0 to 1 open interval for theta in case of Bernoulli theta. It was 0 to infinity open interval for lambda in case of Poisson lambda distribution, etc. If the parameter space is restricted or truncated or curtailed, for example, theta belongs to closed interval 1/4 to 1 in Bernoulli theta, lambda belongs to the open interval 2 to infinity for Poisson lambda, then MLE may change. In this present module, we discuss both informally and formally about MLEs and their characteristics under restricted parameter space. Let us begin with an illustration. Suppose from a Poisson lambda distribution, 10 chosen sample observations are as follows: 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 3, and 0. Denote these observations by a realization vector x equal to x1, x2 up to x10. Then the likelihood function of lambda is capital L lambda equal to e to the power minus 10 lambda into lambda to the power summation I from 1 to 10 xi divided by product over I from 1 to 10 xi factorial. Now from the given data, it is easy to note that the sample mean x bar equal to 1.9 and product over I from 1 to 10 xi factorial equal to 6912. Hence, the likelihood function can alternatively be written as e to the power minus 10 lambda into lambda to the power 19 divided by 6912. A simple plot of log of L lambda against non-negative value of lambda based on the following table gives the plot of log of likelihood against lambda. From the plot, it is evident that the log of likelihood and hence the likelihood itself is parabolic, attaining its maximum at somewhere very close to the value of 2. Now, theoretically, it is not difficult to show that under non-negative lambda values, that is in unrestricted parameter space of Poisson probability model, the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda is the sample mean x bar, which is 1.9 here. So this is supported by the plot which shows the same thing, that the log of the likelihood is maximized at 1.9, which is a very close value of 2. Next, suppose lambda belongs to the closed interval lambda naught to infinity open, where lambda naught, which is a positive number, is known. This means now we are dealing with a restricted parameter space of Poisson lambda distribution. The following cases are obvious to realize, at least informally, from the plot. Case 1. Lambda naught less than equal to x bar less than infinity. That is, x bar lies between lambda naught to infinity. If we go back to the plot, it is clear that in this case, as x bar is included in the region closed interval lambda naught to infinity, the likelihood function within lambda naught to infinity is again maximum at x bar, which implies that the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda is again x bar. Now we go to case 2, which is lambda naught greater than sample mean x bar. As here, the parameter space starts after x bar, so from the plot, it is clear that under the parameter space lambda naught to infinity, likelihood function L lambda is a monotone decreasing function of lambda, which implies that the likelihood function is supremum at lambda naught. This means the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda here is lambda naught itself. So, combining these two cases, we can say that the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda in the restricted parameter space is equal to lambda naught itself, provided the sample mean x bar is less than lambda naught, and the maximum likelihood estimate is as usual x bar if x bar belongs to the closed interval lambda naught to infinity open. Likewise, for the curtailed parameter space, say closed interval lambda naught to lambda 1, where lambda naught is a positive known number and lambda 1 is also known and is greater than lambda naught, the following cases are straightforward to realize, at least from the plot. Case 1. Lambda naught is strictly greater than x bar. Here, at least from the plot, it is clear that the likelihood function L lambda is monotone decreasing function of lambda in this domain, which implies the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda is the lambda naught itself. Now come to case 2, which is lambda 1 less than sample mean x bar. Here, the parameter space can extend at the most up to the sample mean x bar. But from the plot, it is clear that in this region, likelihood function L lambda is monotone increasing in lambda, which implies L lambda attains its supremum at lambda 1. That means the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda is lambda 1 itself. Now come to case 3, where lambda naught less than equal to x bar less than equal to lambda 1. That is, x bar lies within the interval lambda naught to lambda 1. This implies the parameter space includes x bar, and hence the likelihood function L lambda is again maximum at the sample mean x bar, which implies the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda is sample mean x bar again. Combining all these three cases, we can finally say that the maximum likelihood estimate of lambda equal to lambda naught, provided sample mean x bar is less than lambda naught. It is sample mean x bar itself if x bar lies in the closed interval lambda naught to lambda 1. And it is lambda 1 provided x bar is greater than lambda 1. Now consider the illustration with a normal theta 1 distribution, where theta belongs to minus infinity to plus infinity. That is, the parameter space is here unrestricted for theta. As usual, the likelihood is L theta equal to 1 by root over 2 pi n into e to the power minus half summation I from 1 to n xi minus theta whole square minus infinity less than theta less than infinity, which is equal to 1 by root over 2 pi to the power n e to the power minus n by 2 into x bar minus theta whole square into e to the power minus half summation xi minus x bar whole square after a simple manipulation. The exponent involving theta is a square, that is x bar minus theta whole square, which is least, that is takes the value 0 at theta equal to x bar, the sample mean. This implies the likelihood L theta attains its maximum at the sample mean x bar. Using maximum minimum principle also, we can obtain this result. This implies in unrestricted parameter space of theta, the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is the sample mean x bar. That is, if we plot the likelihood function L theta against different values of theta in real line for a given set of sample observations, then L theta reaches its maximum at the value of sample mean. Next, consider the parameter space like closed interval theta naught to infinity for the parameter theta, where theta naught is a known number. The following case gives different MLEs of theta in this situation. First, come to case 1, where sample mean x bar lies between theta naught to infinity, theta naught less than equal to x bar less than infinity. As x bar is included in the restricted parameter space now, so x bar maximizes the likelihood function as usual, and it implies that the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is the sample mean x bar again. Come to case 2, that is theta naught strictly greater than x bar. This implies now the likelihood function L theta is a monotone decreasing function of theta which attains its supremum at theta equal to theta naught, and hence the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is here theta naught itself. So combining these two cases, for normal theta 1 distribution, the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is equal to theta naught if x bar strictly less than theta naught, and equal to x bar itself provided x bar belongs to the closed interval theta naught to the infinity open. Similarly, if the parameter space is like the closed interval theta naught to theta 1, where both theta naught and theta 1 are known, the following cases arise. Case 1. Here theta naught is strictly greater than the sample mean x bar. As usual in the previous cases, here also the likelihood function L theta is monotone decreasing in theta, and which implies that the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is the theta naught itself. Case 2 is theta 1 strictly less than sample mean x bar, which provides that the likelihood function L theta is a monotone increasing function of theta, and as a result, the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is theta 1 itself. Finally, in case 3, we consider the sample mean x bar is greater than equal to theta naught but less than equal to theta 1. Here, the likelihood function L theta is again maximum at the sample mean x bar, which implies the maximum likelihood estimate of theta is the sample mean x bar. Thus, combining all these three cases, the maximum likelihood estimate of theta in this restricted parameter space is theta hat equal to theta naught, provided x bar is strictly less than theta naught, equal to x bar itself, provided x bar belongs to the closed interval theta naught to theta 1, and equal to theta 1 if x bar is strictly greater than theta 1. Now come to a bit generalization of the discussion we have made so far. Let t equal to tx be the maximum likelihood estimator of a parameter theta under full or unrestricted parameter space. This implies under the truncated or restricted parameter space like the closed interval theta star to theta double star, the maximum likelihood estimator is theta hat equal to theta star itself if tx is strictly less than theta star. It is equal to tx if theta star less than equal to tx less than equal to theta double star, and it is equal to theta double star if Tx is strictly greater than theta double star. Now we come to a formal discussion on MLE under restricted parameter space. For this, let us consider the following illustration. Let x1, x2, xn be iid normal mu1 random variables, where mu belongs to the closed interval 0 to infinity open. That is, the parameter space is a restricted parameter space. Now the likelihood function is L mu equal to constant into e to the power minus half summation I from 1 to n xi minus mu whole square, and as a result the log of the likelihood L mu equal to constant minus half summation I from 1 to n xi minus mu whole square. The first order derivative of log of L mu with respect to mu equal to n into x bar minus mu, and the second order derivative of the same is minus n for any mu greater than 0. At mu equal to 0, differentiation with respect to mu is possible only from right hand side. If x bar belongs to the closed interval 0 to infinity, that is, x bar and mu both has the same domain, this implies the maximum likelihood estimate of mu is the x bar as usual. This can be easily checked from the first order condition and the second order condition of maxima minima principle. Now come to the case that is x bar less than 0. This implies the first order derivative of log of likelihood with respect to mu, which is n into x bar minus mu, is strictly negative, because as mu is positive, then minus mu is negative and x bar in this case is considered to be negative. So, the first order derivative of log of L mu is strictly negative for all mu greater than equal to 0. This implies and implied by log of the L mu is monotone decreasing function of mu for all mu greater than equal to 0. And this means L mu is maximized at mu equal to 0. Thus we have here the maximum likelihood estimate of mu equal to x bar itself if x bar is greater than equal to 0, and it is 0 if x bar strictly less than 0. Now come to the asymptotic distribution of mu hat when mu is strictly greater than 0. We can usually write root n into mu hat minus mu as root n into x bar minus mu plus root n into mu hat minus x bar. Let us denote this expression by star. Now, from central limit theorem, it is easy to observe that root n into x bar minus mu converges to normal 0, 1 in distribution for any mu belonging to 0 to infinity. Again, mu hat minus x bar equal to 0 implies mod of root n into mu hat minus x bar less than infinity for every epsilon greater than 0. Hence, we can easily say that probability of mod of root n into mu hat minus x bar less than epsilon is greater than equal to probability of mu hat minus x bar equal to 0, because the event mu hat minus x bar equal to 0 implies the event mod of root n into mu hat minus x bar is less than epsilon. And finally, probability of mu hat minus x bar equal to 0 is same as probability that x bar is greater than equal to 0, which is equal to capital phi of root n into mu, and this converges to 1 as n tends to infinity for mu greater than 0, where capital phi denotes the distribution function of standard normal distribution. This inequality implies that mu hat minus x bar converges to 0 in probability. Hence, finally, from the expression star, we can easily get that root n into mu hat minus mu also converges to normal 0, 1 in distribution simply by using Slutsky's theorem. Now, as a recall, we can say that the Slutsky's theorem is, if x tends to c in probability and y tends to z in distribution, this implies x plus y converges to z plus c in distribution. Next, we come to asymptotic distribution of mu hat when mu equal to 0. In this case, probability that x bar greater than equal to 0 is equal to half for all n. So we cannot say that mu hat minus x bar converges to 0 in probability now. And this implies the distribution function, say capital Fn of root n into mu hat minus 0 is defined as capital Fn y equal to 0 if y is less than 0 and equal to capital phi of root n into y if y is greater than equal to 0, where it is clear that there is a discontinuity at the point y equal to 0. Clearly, this is not normal even asymptotically. Thus, the asymptotic distribution of the maximum likelihood estimate mu hat is normal for all mu belonging to the closed interval 0 to infinity open, except at the boundary point mu equal to 0 of the truncated parameter space. Now come to the comparison of these two maximum likelihood estimators through the MSE criteria. One is the maximum likelihood estimator under unrestricted case, that is x bar as usual, and another is the maximum likelihood estimator mu hat under the restricted parameter space 0 to infinity. In this situation, we will study a result which says that the mean squared error of the maximum likelihood estimator mu hat under restricted parameter space is less than equal to the mean squared error of x bar for all mu belonging to the closed interval 0 to infinity. For a recall, we can say that the mean squared error is a measure or the criteria of goodness of an estimator. Now, how this result is observed, we can make a brief discussion of this. MSE, mean squared error of mu hat, is equal to expectation of mu hat minus mu whole square. Now, mu hat, which is equal to x bar provided x bar greater than equal to 0 and equal to 0 provided x bar less than 0, it can be looked upon as a function of x bar, where the function is x bar if x bar greater than equal to 0 and is 0 if x bar less than 0. So that is why MSE of mu hat is equal to integration 0 to infinity x bar minus mu whole square PDF of x bar dx bar plus integration minus infinity to 0 mu square PDF of x bar into dx bar. And in the similar way, we can write the MSE of x bar. Now, the difference between MSE of x bar with MSE of mu hat is equal to integration minus infinity to 0 x bar into x bar minus 2 mu into PDF of x bar dx bar. So, in this integration, the integrand is x bar into x bar minus twice mu. Now, x bar is less than equal to 0 under the range of integration minus infinity to 0. And also, x bar minus twice mu is less than equal to 0 as mu is greater than equal to 0. So, this implies x bar into x bar minus twice mu is greater than equal to 0, which implies the integrand is non-negative for this integration, and as a result, the integration is also non-negative. So this implies MSE of x bar minus MSE of mu hat is greater than equal to 0, which gives that MSE of x bar is greater than equal to MSE of mu hat. As an implication of this result, we can say that under truncated parameter space, that is closed interval 0 to infinity, of mu for normal mu 1 population, mu hat, which is defined earlier, is a better performing estimator than x bar for estimating mu. Now consider the following note. If mu belongs to the open interval 0 to infinity in the above illustration, then in the similar way as above, but with a slight modification, we could define MLE of mu as mu hat equal to x bar itself provided x bar is strictly greater than 0, and some epsilon star provided x bar is less than equal to 0, where epsilon star is a very small positive number. Here also, we have in the same way, mu hat minus x bar converges to 0 in probability from the definition of convergence in probability. As a result, the asymptotic distribution of mu hat and x bar will become same. For this reason, one can use x bar as the MLE of mu in this situation. In reality, due to many constraints, the parameter spaces are frequently constrained or restricted. This module helped us understand how to get MLE in simple way even under restricted parameter spaces. We also studied the asymptotic distributions of these maximum likelihood estimators under restricted cases, and also showed that the MLEs under these restricted cases are better than the MLEs obtained under unrestricted parameter spaces in the light of the mean squared error.